Moment ein. Besser kann es nicht sein. Denkt an die Tage, die hinter uns liegen, wie lang wir Freude und Tränen schon teilen. Hier geht jeder für jeden durchs Feuer, im Regen stehen wir niemals allein. Und solange unsere Herzen uns steuern, wird das auch immer so sein. Ein Hoch auf das, was vor uns liegt, das ist das Beste für uns gibt. Ein Hoch auf das, was uns vereint, auf diese Zeit,
auf diese Zeit.
Ein Hoch auf uns, uns, auf dieses Leben, auf den Moment, der immer bleibt. Ein Hoch auf uns, uns, auf jetzt und.
Dear students, okay, I'll try it again. Dear students, family, teachers, and staff, it is our pleasure to welcome you guys to the German International School, Washington, D.C., graduation of 2022. Although it's been a long road, sometimes bumpy, sometimes smooth, we finally made it. We're glad, us, the graduation committee, Lena Sedemeyer, April Twin, Sophia Eisele, Daniel Trujillo, and Eva Kutke, and the rest of course, our class of 22, we're glad you can join it in our celebration, and we hope you have fun.
To start our celebration off, we would like to introduce our first student speakers, Annika Nagel, Lily Paris, Nikki Abro, and Magnus Berg, who have all spent their entire school career attending the German International School, Washington, D.C., and will reflect a little bit on their experiences and lessons learned here.
All right. Welcome, staff, students, teachers, families, and of course, a big welcome to our graduating class of 2022. I want to start off by saying how proud I am of each and every one of my peers sitting before me today. We finally made it, guys, and on top of that, through one of the toughest periods humanity has ever faced. So celebrate it, drink it in. This is a big achievement. When I first joined the 12A, also known as the best class at the school, don't worry, 12B, y'all guys came third place, don't worry. Anyway, as I was saying, when I first joined the class, it felt very comfortable. Everybody was really loose. We would pick fun at each other and have fun with each other, but if anyone ever needed any help, there would always be that one person there ready to offer that help. It almost felt like a little family. Speaking of family, I'd like to give a quick shout out to my family, the Agbro family. My family's been attending the school for over 20 years, so it's a big achievement to finally have us all through, so that's nice. Anyways, enough about my family. As you all know, this week we will receive papers that will unlock so many opportunities for us. Our diplomas, or how I like to call them, our get-out-of-jail-free cards. No, jokes aside though, it has been an honor and a privilege to have experienced the past years with this grade, and I wouldn't change it even if I could. Everyone was full of life, and we rarely ever had any dull moments. So I'm excited to see what we all will accomplish in the future, because I'm sure whatever it is, it will be great. Speaking of future, one of our favorite stories we read in class was The Christmas Carol. So as Ebenezer Scrooge was visited by his spirits of the past, present, and the future, tonight we will do the same, but with our own little twist. So at this point, I would like to pass the mic to someone I've known since kindergarten and a longtime classmate of mine, Annika Nacker.
I have the honor to say that the four of us have been attending the German school for over 14 years. Therefore, I would like to take a moment to reflect on some of our favorite memories at the GISW. Together, we watched the school change from one year to the next. The switch of principals, from Herr Gries all the way up to Frau Jung-Bandas. The switch of technology, from chalkboards to whiteboards. From in-person class to online class during the pandemic. But together, we also watched ourselves evolve into the people we are today. A group of outstanding, talented, and ambitious students that I've had the privilege to call my classmates and friends. A unique feature of the GISW is its close sense of community. The fusion between American and German culture and their traditions are something I deeply value about the school. But the traditions only come to life through the people. I still remember the first time I heard Adolfo sing Feliz Navidad before the Christmas holidays, and 14 years later, it sounds just as wonderful. The GISW. The GISW has never failed to bring excitement into our lives, whether it was taking a stuffed animal named Tinto home for a day in first grade and sharing your adventure with the class, or participating in the annual San Martin's Festival on a cold November evening throughout elementary school. But specifically in the past 2 years, while preparing to take the Abitur, we have grown closer as a grade. Not too many people can say they had a graduating class of 29 students. What makes the GISW so special are the people. The people we see every day, the people we make jokes in class with, the people we get to graduate with today. Memories like going to Rehoboth and swimming in the ocean at night, playing soccer against the 12B, and planning our Abischreich where we slept at the school wouldn't be the same without our classmates and teachers. Our classmates who were by our side through all the Abitur stress, and our teachers and families who were there to support us. In particular, Mr. Bishop, our class teacher, who always lifted our spirits with his witty humor. But these are not only memories of the past. They are also building blocks and guiding posts for whatever we may face in the future. I think I speak for all of us when I say that there is no doubt the German school will have a long-lasting impact on us all. But let us take a moment to look at the now. It is my pleasure to introduce to you my lifelong classmate and best friend, Lily Paris.
Currently, we are in the middle of one of the biggest transitions of our lives. During this time, we can find comfort in remembering our fondest memories of the past and dreaming about what is yet to happen in the future. While writing this speech, we did exactly that. We spent hours reminiscing over our funniest memories at the German school, including the terrors of Camp Letz, the GISW's newest art installation, also known as the Classroom of the 12A, and goat yoga with the not-so-potty-trained goats. But equally as much time we spent daydreaming about the future, planning our visits to each other's new homes and colleges, and envisioning the successes our classmates will have. At this time, our past and future uniquely fuse to make an exciting present, which we have the pleasure and honor of sharing with each and every one of you today at our high school graduation. Our graduation marks the end of our time at the German school. It marks not only the culmination of our hard work, but also how much we have grown throughout our childhood. Our growth can be represented through a sequence of very firsts and very lasts at the German school. From making our very first friend in kindergarten to making our last. From writing our very first word to writing our last essay. From our last lunch to our last, from our first lunch to our last, all with Frau Köhler. The present gives us time to reflect on our growth, determination, and grit, which will allow us to walk across this stage today. But the present is not only connected to the past. Graduation, at the same time, is a send-off into the next chapter of our lives. But what's so special about the present is that it's the only time in which we are, act, and do. In the past, we were, we acted, and we did. In the future, we will be, we will act, and we will do. Now is the only time in which we can be. With so much emphasis on our past, on our glorious past at the GISW, and so much anticipation for what the future holds in store for all of us, we cannot forget about the present. So, as Mother Teresa reminds us, we have only today. Let us begin. And with that, I would like to pass the microphone to my friend and classmate, Magnus, who will enlighten us on the future.
Many people fear the future, but I believe our future is going to be so bright, you'll need sunglasses. I also believe our class has some very diverse futures. Some have open and flexible plans, ready for wherever the road takes them, while others know exactly what they want to do. Medicine, business, and art are just a few of the subjects some of our classmates have already decided to major in. Many already have plans to study in the States, and others are bound for Europe. And even beyond university or college, the whole world lays open to us. But even so, I hope that in the future, we as a class maintain contact across both sides of the pond. I, for one, can't wait for the class reunions. Nonetheless, there may be some uncertainty over our success in the future, but the trials and tribulations we have gone through here at the GISW, such as online class and the rigorous Abitur process, have prepared us well for any challenge in the future, no matter what path we take in life. Back to Nikki.
All right. So now that we've learned from our past, we prepare for the future, we must always remember one thing, and that is to live in the present. Which reminds me, we still have a whole program to go through, so that's enough from us for now. But enjoy the rest of your evening. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Annika, Lily, Nikki, and Magnus, for that lovely speech. On our first day here at the GISW, then still called the DSW, we received a single sunflower. And today marks the end of our school career and the start into a new world. And therefore, we would like to thank all the people who have brought us here to this moment and return the sunflower to them. Amandine Gutenberg, we thank you for instilling in us an appreciation for the French language and motivation to continue pursuing this language also after we've graduated. Hello, Matt. We thank you for presenting us how multifaceted chemistry can be and the many future applications of our chemistry knowledge.
Ms. Cropsey, we would like to thank you for your dedication to our English studies, as well as making every class so engaging. You brought us closer to the world of Shakespeare and Jane Austen and introduced us to so many new amazing authors that we may have never discovered if it wasn't for you. Frau Klick, we thank you for jumping in as the 12A German teacher so last minute and helping us when we needed it the most and guiding us through our Abitur. Herr Nikolov, we thank you for being our assistant homeroom teacher and accompanying us to so many journeys, especially in the last 2 years. We thank you for making every Spanish class so lively and supporting us in our linguistic careers.
Ms. Jackson, we thank you for keeping our English class interesting, being supportive and understanding of us. Another teacher that we want to thank, but sadly she's not here, Frau Vorwerk, we thank you and muchas gracias for accompanying us for many years on our journey to acquiring the Spanish language, and we appreciate you being so considerate and understanding as well as perceptive to our unique learning styles. Frau Lohr-Ferrari, we thank you for your interesting and varying sports class, which provided us with a much-needed balance to our academic-centered subjects. It allowed us to pursue our athletic endeavors and gave us the opportunity to try out many other sports.
Hatome, we thank you for guiding and preparing all of us students for at least one Abitur exam. We appreciate your tireless dedication and commitment to our success, as well as helping us prepare for the real world by connecting your classes to it. Ms. Cheshire, we thank you for guiding us students on our own creative and innovative journeys and equipping us with the tools to continue pursuing these passions well beyond our school career. We appreciate being a part of the Mirror Project, which will be part of our legacy we leave at this school. Herr Riga, we thank you for providing us with religious instruction that allowed us not only to reflect on our own religious beliefs, but also to learn and discover those of others around us. This has helped us to become open-minded citizens of the world and is very valuable for our future.
Next, we would like to thank someone very special, Frau Bankert. Frau Bankert, we thank you for being one of our homeroom teachers and being involved in our success for the future for the past 2 years. We thank you for your interesting and challenging biology class, and we appreciate your dedication to our class. Helping things run smoothly, and even throwing us Christmas parties and singing karaoke with us, or buying new fish for the bio room that maybe die, maybe it's our fault, maybe it's not. Last, but most certainly not least, we want to thank Mr. Bishop. Although he couldn't make it, yeah. Although he couldn't make it today, he really, really deserves this huge round of applause. We thank you for watching, for being our homeroom teacher, guiding us from 11th grade to our final exams. We appreciate the hard work and dedication you have shown us to ensure a successful and enjoyable school career for us. sometimes being the only person who kept us motivated, and were willing to talk to anybody to keep us going, or to get us what we want, sorry. To show our true and honest thankfulness towards him, which he really, really deserves. We as a graduation committee, all want to share a memory that we have with him that we're very fond of and will follow us for the rest of our lives. Starting off strong, Mr. Bishop talked to me about how smart and loyal rats are, which I don't even know how we got to the topic of rats, but he did have a way of turning anything into a great conversation. So hopefully he has a pet rat in the future. I don't know, maybe.
One of my fondest moments with Head Bishop was probably on our class trip. He was always up and ready for any adventure, anything we have planned. And it was always very fun when we like sat at the dinner table and he was engaging everybody in conversations. He was always with us as a class.
As a part of the 12A, I can honestly say that we may or may not have been the easiest class to handle. But we want to thank Herr Bishop for always being an amazing homeroom teacher for us and always being so understanding and kind and even cracking jokes in the most serious situations.
I think my favorite memory with Mr. Bishop was probably swimming in Rehoboth at night, and he came with us, he would accompany us wherever, even though it was kind of crazy. So yeah, thanks to him for that.
Two more things about him. Apart from him being a great teacher, he was a great friend. This more personal experience was during spring break that we went to celebrate Easter. And coincidentally, he was also going to be in Hamburg at the same time that we were going to go. So it was really nice. The one day that we met in the main plaza, later after that, we just went to a Biergarten in Hamburg, and we talked about soccer, we talked about classes, and maybe even a little bit about Abitur. So that was a great memory. And the other that it's more related to more people is just all the great soccer talks about teams, about players, and also all the talks about movies and series. We deeply thank you, Herr Bishop.
As we share these experiences that we've all had with our most amazing teacher, we hope that every student has an opportunity to have a teacher like Mr. Bishop. Two other people the school couldn't function without is, of course, and people we wouldn't get our degree without is our principal, Frau Jung-Wanders, and our Oberstufenkoordinatorin, Frau Strauss. We would like to thank you for getting every single one of us, all 29 in this room, through the past 2 years, and it is an honor to receive our diploma from you.
My dear students, abiturientin, seniors, graduates, whatever. Dear parents, families, colleagues, staff, and guests. It's really amazing and an honor for me that I'm not only tasked with handing out your Abitur certificates tomorrow, but that I also get to hand out your high school diploma today. The high school diploma marks the end of the secondary education in the US after 12 years of school, but what really counts are the last and most difficult 4 years. The diploma you are about to receive soon is the only school leaving certificate issued in the US education system, and one that is recognized all over the United States. But compared to the Deutsche Internationale Abitur Certificate, it's not automatically your ticket into a university or college. There is the need to prove your knowledge via the SAT, ACT, transcripts, etc., or the International Baccalaureate. In Germany, the high school diploma is recognized as well as the Mittlerer Schulabschluss, Realschulabschluss, or depending on the subjects and languages taken, as the Fachoberschulreife. My sincere congratulations to all of you and your parents and families for having achieved this diploma, even in a German school, which means a lot more time and difficult. Congratulations. And please remember, for every ending, there is a new beginning. For every dream achieved, there is a memory to hold it. For every challenge conquered, there is a new one to embrace. I hope you'll go out there now and make the best of this diploma. Enjoy this evening, and thank you all for your work to organize this evening for us as well.
Thank you so much for those inspiring words. And now let's get into what we're all here for, a graduation. Starting off strong with Nikki Akbro.
If young Metro don't trust you, I'm gonna show you. Beautiful morning. Yeah, the sun in my morning bed. Nothing in the water. Beautiful morning. Yeah, the sun in my morning bed. Nothing in the water. I just wanna feel liberated. I just wanna feel liberated. If I ever get to gay, I'm sorry. Tell me who ain't here to relate. If I fuck this model and she just bleached her asshole, and I get bleach on my t-shirt, I'ma feel like an asshole. I was high when I met her. We was down in Tribeca. She get under your skin if you let her. She get under your skin if you, I don't even want to talk about it.
Up next we have Magnus Berg. We have Christian Boguslav. Up next is Ken Brandstetter. Next we have Hannah Deschler. We have Luke Detlefsen.
Now we will continue with Vanessa Dietz. Up next, Markus Grieb.
Ah, Sophia. Sorry, Sophia Eisele.
that was my mistake, obviously. I'm sorry, everyone. Next up, we have Sophia Eiseller. Now let's continue with the right order, Simon Grüninger. Coming up next, Lena Hoffmann. Next, Alma Cangas.
Eva Kuttke. Madeleine Lissina. Now Leon Lütke.
Yeah. I want it all. I want it all. And I want it now.
Adventure seeker on an empty street. Just an alley.
Now, Lara Molitor. Next, Annika Nagel. Now we have Luisa Nasri. Next, we have Marie Nellis. Next, we have Fabian Nix.
Woo! Next, we have Florian Nix. Next, Lily Paris.
I'm gonna have myself a real good time.
Sonja Reichelt. Luisa Schulz.
Next is Lena Sedelmeier. Next is Daniel Trujillo.
Pero hoy salió el sol y me siento mejor. La mala pasó, el tiempo es mi doctor. La vida es una movie, soy mi propio director. Prendan, prendan y tráiganme en alcohol. Que no tengo tiempo para guardar rencor. Yo no cojo lucha y me. Abraza a tu hermano, mires el color, que aquí todos somos iguales. Cuanto tú ames, eso es lo que vales. Hoy voy a hacer un truco en la lomba, pero si no me sale.
Up next is April Twin.
I lived. Hope that you spend your days, but they all add up.
Up next is Noah van Straalen. And last but not least, Paul van Redeker.
How you get so much favor on your side? Accept them as your Lord and Savior, I replied. That's your love, that neighbor, not the bad. I'm a rat, that's on God. His light shine the brightest in the dark. Single mothers know they get my heart. And all my brothers locked up on the yard. You can still be anything you wanna be. Went from 1-4 to 1-3. 13th Amendment got an end, that's on me. He the new commander and the chief. That's on Keith, that's on Cobb. Before the ranch I had horses in the garage. When the Forbes cover was just a mirage. They had me changing statues, that's on pride. Oh my God, Buster, that's on tribe.
Please give it up one last time for our graduating class of 2020. Before we can end our celebration, we have a few last words by Hannah Deschler and April Twin. Dear students, dear teachers, dear family, dear Frau Jung-Wanders, dear friends, dear members of the community.
Potomac carries different meanings for all of us. Some of us will say it's simply a river that connects two different states. Others will say it connects half of our grade that lives in Maryland and the other half that lives in Virginia. But the word Potomac translated actually means river of swans.
Just like swans, we have all changed our color ever since those sunflowers were handed to us during our Einschulung, and we began our journey of swimming. Had it not been for the support of you teachers, I don't think I would be where I am today. Special thanks to Mr. Bishop and Frau Bankert. We will never forget the morning walks, midnight beach dips with snacks, trying to photosynthesize,
or watching the suns come across the waves. The school has truly taught me that learning is not about grades, but about lifelong lessons.
While it is true that our hardworking teachers have given us a thorough understanding of the world, I have also learned so much from my fellow 28 students who we are proud to know. Luisa, Maureen, and Anika have taught me how to be kinder. Kent, Madeline, Luisa, Noah, and Paul have taught me how to be brave and stand up for what I believe in. April, Sophia, Lara, and Lily, how to have passion towards learning and helping those around me. And Fabian, Florian, Luke, and Magnus, you have taught me that napping on the couch and chairs is possible before class, and of course also how to lift up people's spirits.
Sonia, Leon, Alma, and Vanessa have taught me how to be well prepared. Hannah, Lena, Lena, Eva, Nikki, how to be artistic and creative. And Christian, Marcus, Simon, Daniel, and Noah, how to take everything with a grain of salt and enjoy life. But after today, we will no longer have the river of swans to float on. The ending of our paths is no longer visible, and none of us know exactly what the days after the summer will look like. The people that have accompanied us, that have shaped us for such an important part of our lives, will each follow their own paths.
I am sure all of us have at least once asked ourselves, how will we stay afloat after leaving the people we have spent years, or for many even their entire lives with? No more touring in Colonia Williamsburg, no more boba trips during the Freistunden, and we have already played our last A versus B soccer game.
But that is why it's important to remember that while we all might be taking our own paths from now on, the memories and the knowledge we have gained from this community have lifted us up. We have been gifted the ability to fly.
While there may no longer be that many class pictures to add to our shared album, except for those taken today, the album will always have a special place on our phones and in our memories.
While there may no longer be more mini golfing in Rehoboth with terrible music playing in the background, we are all now experts at blocking out distractions to focus on our goals.
While we will no longer have bad food experiences like we did in Camp Letts or our countless failed camping trips, we now know what it feels like to persevere through and in the wilderness. On a side note, there will be a buffet after this speech, and let's hope that that memory will be equally unforgettable, but in the best possible way.
While we might never be able to visit Hank again at the Maritime Museum, we are all properly equipped with oyster knowledge for the real world.
So I hope that as you look at the diploma in your hand, you not only think of change, not just about the fact that the path ahead looks choppy and that the ending is perhaps not completely visible.
I hope that you see the diploma in your hands as a token of the hard work that it took for you to get to this point. I mean, let's be for real. If you can survive chemistry class, I think you will be able to survive a lot of the obstacles that you will have to face in your future journey.
And finally, I hope that you also think of all of the memories and the changes the school has given you. You can choose the direction you are taking. You can choose where this path leads to.
To the class of 2022, we built our own river of memories. We are now ready to fly. We are literally on top of this world.
Thank you very much.
Take it in, but don't look down.
I'm on top of the world, eh? I'm on top of the world, eh? Waiting on this for a while now. Paying my dues to the dirt. I've been waiting to smile, eh? Been holding it in for a while, eh? Take you with me if I can. Been dreaming of this since a child. I'm on top.
tried to cut these corners, try to take the easy way. I kept on falling short of something. I could have gave up then, but then again I couldn't have, cause I've traveled all this way for something. I take it in, but don't look down.
Cause I'm on top of the world.
Vergolden uns diesen Tag.